Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. This is Side Rental Vlogs and today I have come with a very important video which was requested. I was getting requests for a long time. So today I'm going to show you all the angulations which we need to take for taking maxillary and mandibular IOPS or radiographs. So in today's demonstration video, I'll just show you one patient. He is my assistant actually, and I will show you with what should be the head position for which particular type of tooth. What should be the angulation? I will not particularly take the x-ray. I will just show you the angulations for different tooth and how to set your this x-ray machine and how to set the head of the patient. So we all know before starting the procedure of any x-ray, we need to know that for maxillary tooth, the head should be tipped down so that the Frankfurt horizontal plane should be parallel to the floor. And for the mandibular teeth, so I'll show you what I'm telling. So as you can see here, so this is the maxilla. And we are taking the x-ray of the upper anterior tooth, right? So what is there, as you can see, head is slightly tipped downwards and with this Frankfurt horizontal plane should be parallel to the floor. So I am just focusing this x-ray cone along the anterior tooth. So while taking the x-ray, we have to keep in mind that whatever film you are using, suppose you are using a RVG or you are using your IOPA film. So while using the IOPA film, you should be aware to, you should position it properly. So IOPA, you have to tell the patient to open the mouth. Then we have to place it right here so that 1/3 or 1/4 of the film is, you can see it outside. And this is the way, this is the angle with which this is around 45 degree for upper anterior tooth. So this is the way, as you should not take the x-ray like this, tell the patient to, if you take the x-ray like this, x-ray will never come. Either it will come elongated or it will come foreshortened. If why it is elongated, suppose the vertical angulation is too high. For suppose I am doing this and I am doing the x-ray like this. Okay. So whenever you are doing the RCT of the patient, what will happen is the tooth will come foreshortened. Right? But if I do it like this, then also the x-ray won't come. Otherwise, what will happen? There will be elongation of the tooth. So you have to give the proper angulation and proper head position, which we often make mistakes. So this is the correct head position for the upper anterior tooth. Now we see here the mid sagittal plane is perpendicular to the floor and the horizontal, this is the vertical angulation, this is the horizontal angulation. The central x-ray beam should be passing from the interproximal areas of the teeth, as we all know, we have studied in the book. Today is the only demonstration. I'm not going to tell you too much detail into angulation or bisecting angle technique or parallel technique. This is just the angulation for bisecting angle technique. Parallel technique, we need different kind of devices, ring XCP devices, whatever we need to use. Now, suppose now we come to the lateral incisor. Lateral incisor, we have to be similar to the upper anterior tooth, just we have to deviate it more distally. So this is for the lateral incisor tooth. Suppose again we want to take the x-ray of the canine. See, canine is the most mandibular canine and maxillary canine. It's very tricky because canine root is always long. Sometimes it is even 28 millimeters. So what we have to see, we have to see the palate of the patient. Whether it is a high arch palate or it's a shallow arch palate. So usually in patients with shallow arch palate, what we need to do is we need to tip the head more downwards and we have to give a more positive angulation. Suppose you are giving for anterior 45 to 50 degrees, for canine we need to give approximately 60 to 65 degrees. And how you will achieve it? You will tell the patient to look downwards toward the legs and then we have to position the cone accordingly. So this is the way you will take for the canine. And canine is, guys, mind it is very tricky. Sometimes even if you are using IOPA, sometimes you will see the either the crown has got cut or the periapex has got cut. So you can either put the IOP film little bit tilted. That is also a technique for putting x-rays of the upper canine. Similarly for the premolars, we need to, again, the head position is similar. It's constant in all the cases, as you can see. And here you see again the head is down and we need to tip it little bit downward. So head is always down for all the maxillary teeth, right? So this is for the premolars. And guys, if you properly angulate, all the first and second premolar and first molar and second molar will come in one IOPA. If you are using an IOPA film or if you are using a RVG, RVG sensor is very short plus it is thick. So you cannot position it properly in the posterior areas of the oral cavity. So RVG, if you are using, that will be a little bit difficult for you. You need to place the RVG sometimes vertically in order to take the image, right? So again, now this is for the maxillary tooth. Maxillary, again the angle is 30 to 35 degrees Celsius plus 30 degrees. And you should not be doing it like this. Sometimes what happens is, while taking the x-ray of the maxilla, suppose you are doing the root canal of the maxillary tooth, and what happens is, you cannot see the parietal canal sometimes because of the presence of the zygoma. Zygoma jo bone hota hai na, ye malar prominence hota hai, ye U shape kabhi kabhi kisi patient mein aata hai. To humko parietal root nahi dekhta hai, so you need to take 2-3 different angulations. For example, aapne maxilla ka, aapne aise karke liya, thoda sa anti, matlab ki mesially karke liya, thoda sa straight karke liya, thoda sa distally karke liya. So that way you can get the angulation for the maxilla, and sometimes you need to straighten it little bit and tell the patient to tilt the head totally downwards, and then you can just take the x-ray like this. And you need to focus on the parietal root. See, you have to visualize a little bit in your mind ki, okay, where is my x-ray film and where is my cone. So this, you have to try to make this plane parallel to the film plane, right? So this is the way you should take the maxillary radiographs. So I am not showing all the radiographs to you. This is the angulation which I am going to show to you. Now we'll move on to the lower anterior teeth. And for the lower anterior teeth, you can see here a little bit. I'll tell the patient to tip the head backwards. So when I'm doing the lower anterior teeth, I will place my X-ray film like X-ray cone like this. So this is angulation in which you will achieve a perfect radiograph for the lower anterior teeth. Similarly for the canine, you need to shift the cone like this. Then for the, again for the premolars, you need to shift the cone like this, and molars again like this. So this is the technique for lower molars and lower anteriors. Lowers to usually easy hota hai. Kabhi kabhi kya hota hai, lower anterior mein U shape arch hota hai. Then you need to bend the film if you are using IOPA, or if you are using RVG, it is little bit difficult. You need to place the RVG more posteriorly. Agar aap regular radiographs le rahe hain, then aapko pata hoga main kya bol raha hu. कभी कभी टंग टाई हो जाता है किसी किसी पेशेंट में, तब उनमें लोअर एंटीरियर का आरसीटी लेना बहुत डिफिकल्ट होता है. ऐसे बहुत सारे प्रॉब्लम्स आती है हम लोग को रेडियोग्राफ लेने में. तो कीप प्रैक्टिसिंग, डोंट गेट स्केयर्ड फ्रॉम टेकिंग रेडियोग्राफ. अगर आप जितना प्रैक्टिस करेंगे, थोड़ा बहुत अपने फ्रेंड्स के साथ या अपने असिस्टेंट के साथ प्रैक्टिस करिए कि कैसे आपका अच्छा एक्सरे आएगा. एक बार आपने अच्छा एक्सरे लेना सीख लिया, देन यू वोंट हैव एनी काइंड ऑफ प्रॉब्लम्स. सो ऑलरेडी मेरे प्लेलिस्ट मैंने अपनी बना ली है मेरे चैनल पे. आप कोई भी टॉपिक आप सोचिए बीडीएस के बारे में या फिर डेंटिस्ट्री के बारे में, वो प्लेलिस्ट में जाके देखिए. उसमें मैंने बहुत सारे प्लेलिस्ट में वीडियोस बनाई है. रेडियोलॉजी के ऊपर भी ये जाएगा प्लेलिस्ट रेडियोलॉजी वाले में. तो वहां पे और भी हाउ टू टेक मैक्सिलरी एक्सरे मैंने और भी वीडियोस बनाए हैं, कौन सा आरबीजी ले या आईओपीए ले, विच इज बेटर, ऐसे काफी कंपेरेटिव वीडियोस बनाए हैं. और भी काफी सारे टॉपिक्स हैं जॉब्स को लेकर, गवर्नमेंट जॉब्स को लेकर, हाउ टू गो टू अब्रॉड आफ्टर पीडीएस. तो अभी तक 325 वीडियोस बना चुका हूं. तो अगर आप, हर कोई वीडियो आपका इन्फॉर्मेटिव रहेगा आप लोगों के लिए. और अगर आप इस चैनल को ज्वाइन करना चाहते हैं तो सब्सक्राइब बटन करिए और लाइक करिए. और यू कैन ऑल्सो ज्वाइन मी एज अ मेंबर इन दिस चैनल. टिल देन हैव अ वेरी गुड डे, टेक केयर, बाय बाय.